gonna clown me like that, Jasmine?
No.
You gonna clown me like that?
No. It sounded good. It sounded really good to me.
Oh, for real? Mm-hmm. Okay. Honey Bee, Jasmine Sullivan, buzzed on your radio on the all new iPower 92.1 interactive hip hop and R&B. Jasmine is trying to clown me. Are you really trying to clown
I'm
me?
I'm really not. I think that
Let me hear you sing it.
I need you. I need you. What I gotta do? I need you. I need you. Do it all for you. Hey, you sound just like that.
Yes, girl.
You do.
You just taught me a thing or two. I didn't even know I could do all that, but you just taught me that. Everybody, we got Jasmine Sullivan in
What's up?
So let me know about you. Like, I've heard about you. You're buzzing all over the place. I heard you're the truth. But I'm trying to figure... Look, don't make that face like you don't know.
Like, how do you respond to that?
Like, you're right.
I heard you the bomb.
I am the bomb.
I really am the bomb.
No, but, like, I heard you, like, the next big thing. Like, you're already big, but... What do you want the people to know about you? Because a lot of people, we play your song, you have the most requested song, but they don't really know who you are. They haven't really seen you. And if you want to see her right now, log on to the webcam. It's iPower921.com. But they don't know really about you. They don't know that much. So tell them something about you.
Well, I'm just, you know, a regular, you know, girl that just was blessed and had the opportunity to make music. Make music that I love to do. And my label, they fully support me, and I wrote every song on the album.
Wow.
And that's, you know, people don't, a lot of artists don't get a chance
to do that.
So I'm just really blessed. I get to do what I love.
Right.
So I'm here promoting, going everywhere, trying to get people to get that album. It's called Fearless, and it's coming out September 16th.
Right.
So, yeah.
Okay, so you wrote the song, I Need You Bad.
Yes, I did. I wrote it with Missy.
Elliot.
You know, that's Peppa on the song.
Yeah,
so me and Missy, we've been friends for a long time.
Wow.
I met her when I was about 12 or 13.
Right.
I used to go around singing for a bunch of people. I sang for Diddy, Wyclef, everybody.
Right.
I used to go around. But Missy was one of the people that was like, oh my gosh, this girl can sing. When I got signed to Jive when I was 16, she wanted to be a part of my project. And she actually helped the situation because everybody at the label was like, yo, why does Missy Elliott want to work with this girl? So they start getting interested. The deal didn't work out, but Missy still, you know, she had my back and she worked with me at Jay and we did the song. And, you know, she's just a good friend of mine, just very supportive.
So was that a personal experience, the whole I Need You Bad? Or is that just you felt like girls could relate to you?
I felt like everybody could relate to the song messing up and wanting somebody back and when I write songs, you know, some of them are personal, but some of them aren't. Some of them are for my listeners. Like, I write so that people can feel it, so they're real situations. It might not actually have happened to me, but it's always real. So
okay, so where are you from?
I'm from Philadelphia.
We hear the whole little Jamaican. Everybody's calling me like, where's she from? She from the island? She from Caribbean? I'm like,
oh no, I cannot. What is it? Patois? I cannot speak Patois. You heard me say it. I'm like, hey baby, what you do? It do not sound the same.
Yeah, you're silly.
I'm from Philly.
How old are you?
I'm 21.
21? Mm-hmm. You're around my age. I'm 20.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow. Yay, let's hang out.
We need to, girl. We need to hang out. Yeah, okay, so I hear that you wrote the song, Say I, for Christina Milian.
Yeah, it was actually intended for my album that was supposed to come out with Jive Records. But when I got dropped, the song was sold to Christina. And that was really like my first hand in writing and people seeing me as a writer. So it didn't work out with Jive, but I'm glad that Christina Milian did it. And, you know, I got some experience writing, so.
Right. Are you single? I know the dudes be after you.
Huh?
I know they be after you. They see you. They like, yo, she's real pretty. Are you single?
Yes, I am.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of guy you like?
I usually go for musicians.
Mm-hmm.
Just because, I don't know. There's something so attractive about a musician.
So who you got a crush on in the industry? Who you got a crush on?
Andre 3000.
Are you serious?
I don't know. He's the bomb to me.
You met him before?
No, but he's actually, he might be on one of my songs on my album, so.
Oh, that's going to be hot. He's like one of the hottest. He made like MTV's top something. He's hot.
Yeah, so I hope it all goes through.
Wow, so what else are you aspiring to do besides just singing? You're just gorgeous.
Thank you.
You are.
Thank you.
You should be a model.
As you peer into my eyes.
You are so silly. What else do you want
to
do?
I like to do every and anything.
Right.
The name of the album is entitled Fearless because that's just where I'm at right now. Like,
right.
I'm not scared to try different things or do stuff that's out of the box. Like, I was listening to the radio and it's not like any songs that sound like,
exactly,
you know, my song, and that's a big step for a new artist to take, and I'm just ready to do whatever. So could be acting, it could be modeling, if somebody want to take a picture, whatever.
You were so snap the picture. Okay, so what advice could you give for young girls that are either trying to get in the industry or people just that are your age that just want to do whatever? What advice could you give to them?
Well, for young girls, I just want to say to just be yourself and embrace what it is that makes you different. Because when you get into this industry, it could be a lot of people trying to change you and make you, you know, a certain thing that you're not.
Exactly.
So you have to stand strong and know who you are and just accept it and do you and be creative and all of that.
Let me take my number total. You were so silly. Yes, we're going to actually jump back into I Need You Back because people are like, oh, yeah, I know who she is now. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to take some phone calls if that's cool with you.
Oh, sure.
804-345-92FM. Or if you're inside the chat room, it's iPower921.com. If you got questions, hit us up. We're about to jump right back into her song. It's I Need You Back.
I give a shout out.
Girl, go ahead and give me a shout out.
I want to give a shout out to my husband, for God, oh, hey, my sisters, my mother, my best friend. She's ready to have her first baby. And of course, myself.
Gotta show yourself love.
Of course.
Who is this?
This is Jernay.
Jernay, where you calling from?
Southside, of course.
Thank you for calling.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, they are loving you.
Yeah.
They are loving you.
Wow.
How you feel about that? You get shown a lot of love everywhere you go?
So far, yeah, it's not a lot of haters. It's just real positive energy. So I feel really good because I put my heart,
we can tell,
my soul into this album, and I've been doing this for so long. A lot of people don't know I started singing when I was a baby in church.
Yeah,
but
I heard you were on Showtime at the Apollo.
Yeah,
how was that?
That was cool. It was a long time ago. I barely remember. If it wasn't for the YouTube clips, I wouldn't even remember.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You're supposed to remember stuff like that.
I've been doing this for so long.
Right.
So, I mean, I'm grateful that everything's happening.
So did you grow up with, like, people in your family that were singers or musicians, or did you just, it's just a natural talent for you?
The crazy thing is that it's not a lot of singers in my family.
Right.
It's like maybe, like, two others and... It's not like they tried to. My mom used to sing, but it wasn't like, you know, it wasn't like it's singers like the Clark Sisters or anything like that or the Winans. But, yeah.
What do you do in your spare time? You be on MySpace?
Yeah.
What's your MySpace? What's your MySpace?
MySpace.com/Jasmine Sullivan. So y'all go check that out.
And you got your music all posted up there and stuff, right?
Yes, I do. Or you can go to www.jasminesullivanmusic.com.
Right. So if someone wanted to get in contact with you, is that via MySpace, or how would they do that?
They could go on my MySpace or the website I just gave you. Or you could call 215-789-4753 and, you know, just get updates of what I'm doing.
Repeat that one more time so they can get it.
215-789-4753. Right. You just can get updates of what I'm doing, shows, where I'm going to be at. So y'all go call the number, check everything out.
And you brought me a CD. I have a CD here, the Angie Martinez from Hot 97 in New York. She's on this. She's hosting it. And the song I want to play for them is called, hold on, let me stop the music, Bust Your Windows. You one of them psycho chicks? Them psycho girlfriends?
I am not.
look, you were about to say, I am.
No, listen, but a lot of girls and a lot of men that I've ran into have been through that situation. Like I said, I try to write real situations.
Exactly.
And, you know, so it can touch people.
Right. So let's play this. You intro this real quick.
It is called Bust Your Windows, ladies. It's a ladies' anthem, and fellas, don't do anything to get your windows busted.
Jasmine Sullivan right here at Power 92.1.